I've always felt like this. I can't count on anybody else but myself to take care of me. Then that's the way that I've been able to be independent for most of my life. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I don't count on other people. Like, not to say I can't count on them, but I just don't put it in my, it's not in part of my plan for living. Let's say me and you live together, right? Well, after we got married, it's different. I did start counting on you. But when I was in relationships, if I'm going to move somewhere, I need to know that I can take care, I can stay here by myself. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to go live somewhere that's $5,000.
And you know
when I make $2,000 a month.
$2,500.
No, I'm not doing that
shit. You don't go into a situation knowing you can only afford half of everything.
Exactly.
You have to be able to afford all of it.
Because if something doesn't work out, now what? Mm-hmm. Either you got to go somewhere else. And if you don't have a backup plan, your family, you already know your family ain't letting you come stay there, or you don't want to, then you need to make sure you can take care of that household by your damn self.
But now, there are certain instances, there are certain,
unique
circumstances, certain circumstances where you might be able to do that, but you have to be one skillful son of a gun.
To do what?
To, for instance, when I moved in with you, mm-hmm. I don't have any savings, mm-hmm. but I knew that if something happened with us, I was going to be able to go get another place without mm-hmm. a problem. I had a job, but I still didn't have the money for a down payment. But I would have came up with money for a down payment. Legally, I would have came up because there's always ways to make money if you know how to make
exactly.
some money.
That's the thing. I hate to say this. I feel like some people, there's two things. I feel like some people are a little bit lazy. Mm-hmm. And then also some people don't know how to do things or may not be as many opportunities where they live. Mm-hmm. In L.A.,
yeah,
bitch,
L.A., yeah.
You can get money. Mm-hmm. You can get money, especially now. I mean, it's easy. There's ways, and legal ways, a lot of them.
And an excuse, and I agree with what you said when you said sometimes people don't know.
Yeah.
Because I know when I was 17, there were things that I did not know that I could have done. Because I was in a pretty much bad situation from 17 to 19. I just wasn't doing well because I didn't know there were certain things. It was just all kind of shit.
This shit going. Maybe this will be after the buck bomb. I might cut this in. No, keep going. Let's keep it going.
So,
because I got some other shit to say. Now I got attitude.
So, fuck. So what it is, you know, at 17, and please don't be like, oh, Tasha, I'm sorry. I'm grown. I'm happy, all this. But I'm saying this for other people who are going through this right now, young people or people who are still suffering the after effects. Because I suffered the after effects for years just thinking about my 17-year-old life and being like, that shit wasn't fair. But if I would have known some of the things that I know now, like, okay, for instance, I'll tell you this. When I was 17, I finished high school, and I was living with my grandmother. I didn't have any money. I had just had heart surgery, so I couldn't work, right there at the time. I didn't have any money whatsoever. My grandmother was not going to give me any money, and she didn't have to. That was my grandmother, not my mother. So I was basically just living in my grandma's house with nothing. No money to eat. I'm talking about not a dollar. No money for transportation to get to wherever. I wanted to go to college. So I applied for financial aid. I filled the paperwork out wrong. And they sent it back to me and was like, oh, you filled it out wrong. Because back in the end, you had to write your financial aid. You couldn't do it. Now you can do everything online. So I filled it out wrong. They sent it back and was like, nah, you don't call up. You didn't do it right. So then I'm like, well, now I can't go to college. Just being dumb or just not knowing. I was like, oh, I can't go and take these classes that I've already enrolled in because I don't have financial aid. So I'm not going to have money for a book. So I'm not going to be able to do any of the work. If I would have thought, or if I would have known, or somebody would have told me, you can go to the library on campus and read those books and do your work there. I didn't even know I could do that. Mm-hmm. So I didn't go to college then. I still went a few months later, but I ended up going to UEI. And it was just a pattern of not knowing and just living this not like I wanted to live, not like I thought my life was life.
All right, battery died on us, so this is officially after the mukbang. I'm gonna move this because I hate food sitting in front of me that I'm not eating. Okay,
that's syrup. No, I'm not finished.
Okay, go ahead.
So I said all that to say, I don't remember what I said all that to say, but it took me a few years to have the hustle mindset. That's what I'll say. And I feel like I was at some point lazy, because I started smoking weed. You know, I'm with this girl that's doing all this stuff. I enrolled in school. I'm in school for 6 months. Get with her. A month after I'm with her, I'm smoking weed, cigarettes, and I dropped out of school. All in a matter of 1 month. You can get in the wrong relationship. And I'm not blaming that person. I'm blaming myself. But that was me being weak. Then the weed started making me lazy. I wasn't doing nothing. Ended up going to jail. Now, the jail thing was not my fault. But if I wasn't around that person, I would have never went to jail because they would have never came for her. But after that, then I have a record. I have a misdemeanor of resisting arrest. So there, then I can't get a job. And it was just a pattern of stuff, you know, and some people give up. I think at that point, some people are like, well, I might as well start doing, you know, but you have to think about your life, like the future. You can't say, oh, I can't get a job right now, so let me just start doing illegal stuff. So then when you get caught doing something, you can't mess your life up. We only have one. And trust me, they want to put you in jail and lie. Some people. But I mean, if you do something criminal, you should, you know, pay for it. But the point is, you don't want some shit on your record. Go ahead.
I was just going to talk about the lazy people, because a lot of y'all over here asking us for some money. Okay. And I'm talking about people in our real lives. Okay. I need you to do the work, because we work our asses off. If we can do stuff, y'all can do stuff. Okay. We've done all kinds of shit. We've done Postmates, DoorDash, fucking Instacart, Amazon, bitch, Flex. All that shit. We've done all that shit.
Field Nation. Y'all don't even know what that is.
Exactly. Okay.
Yes. Prostitution.
Fuck you.
Shut your ass up. We haven't done that.
No, hell no. Everything has been legal. But I'm saying, like, during different points of our lives when we needed more money, we did what we needed to do to get it. And there are some people who are lazy as fuck, and they keep getting help from every motherfucking body. And it's not fair, because we already work for ourselves. Now we got to work for everybody to give else. You money too. Mm-hmm. That's not fair. Why am I doing extra work, mm-hmm. but you are chilling, mm-hmm. smoking your weed, mm-hmm. chilling,
mm-hmm. not doing much?
You could work harder.
Yeah,
work harder. There's times that we've done some shit, y'all. We have done a lot of hard working.
Care about our child, okay? Do you understand? Before Stephanie came along, before Elijah came along, I was just fucking floating by, right? Once I had a kid, my whole entire mind changed. And besides that one time when Elijah was a baby, once I moved out on my own when Elijah was one from my ex, you never saw me living with anybody else. They might have lived with me. But living with anybody else, or I never asked nobody for. I'm not saying it's not okay to ask somebody for something if you pay it back. There's nothing wrong with asking. There's nothing wrong with saying, I need some help. Mm-hmm. If you're really working towards, I'm not saying anything's wrong with that. I'm just saying that I didn't ask anybody because I knew how to get stuff. Mm-hmm. I figured it out at this point. I had a kid and I knew that he didn't ask me to be here. Mm-hmm. I wanted him. So now I have to figure out whatever the hell I got to do. I don't care if I have to work till my fingers fall off. I got to take care of this child that didn't ask me to be here. And I have to buy him toys that he wants to have, because kids are supposed to have fun. The Elijah comes into Stephanie's life. Same thing for her. She took on that role, and we work for ourselves. Don't get us wrong. We're individuals. We have a kid, but we're also individuals. You got to love yourself and take care of yourself too. But we moved to Santa Monica just to put him in a better school. There was no other reason why. We didn't have to move to Santa Monica. We didn't have no YouTube money when we went to Santa Monica. We just had our income. We doubled. Our rent doubled when we moved to Santa Monica.
Exactly.
And we made it work with no YouTube money or anything.
When we moved there, that shit was outside of our comfort zone as far as financially. But we was like, we got to make this shit work.
Mm-hmm.
Because we wanted to have him in that school, period.
Yeah.
So we made it work.
We made it work.
We was going to do whatever we had to do. Yeah. No matter how many hours we had to work, it was going to get done.
And we were doing that. We were doing that before we. And so I say that to say, if you have a child and you're lazy, shame on you.
When we were coming up, when we were younger, 17, 18, 19, 20, whatever, we didn't have apps and internet to. Internet was there, but it wasn't like it is now, where you can literally type up shit and get so many ideas of how to make money. You can look at other people making money and figure out some shit. You can go on different apps and sign up and make money. We didn't have that. But I feel like we both still were really, like, we had our minds open to different ways to make money. Like, I was always looking for ways. Should I be like, I'll just run into anything and I'll be like, how can I fucking use this to make money? Mm-hmm. Like, at one point, I started selling tickets. So I would go on Ticketmaster and try to get, like, I would look up all the concerts, let's say, coming up for the next 6 months. I'll write them down on the calendar the day they come up. Let's say if it's 10 a.m. I go on Ticketmaster at 10 a.m. and be on there. You have to, it's like, the browser is like, fucked up, but I'll be on that motherfucker until I get some good tickets. Get them up, post them bitches on Craigslist or wherever I need to post them and sold them. Like, there's different things I did throughout my life like that. But I would always have my mind open to, how can I make money off of something? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that's what you got to do. I was going to say, for people that don't know, now y'all have a lot more resources to do this shit. If I was broke and needed something, I would be online finding out how people making money, mm-hmm. and try shit. You know, there's a lot of things. Don't get caught up in scams that's trying to get your money. But I would try so many things until something worked.
There are a lot of ways.
When we did YouTube, that was one of those things.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That was one of our things that may or may not work.
Exactly.
And it did. Mm-hmm. We both continue to take classes, go to school, get degrees. I technically don't have a degree because I never...
They never gave me the degree.
I took all the classes, but I applied for it, but it was too late. So I had to... I didn't feel like going back up to the school. So I technically... don't have an associate.
No, you technically do have one.
I technically have one, but I don't actually have one. Right. I can go to the school and get it, but I just haven't done it, and I probably won't. But I have certifications. I have the LVN and all, whatever. The tax thing. You see, we just have different things that we've done. You got to try different things. And, like, go to the H&R Block thing. They're not going to pay that much, but you go to H&R Block, you learn how to do taxes. Then you start doing your friends' taxes, right? You charge them. Don't charge them a whole lot. Charge them whatever, less than what H&R Block would charge them. They're going to refer their friends to you, and it's going to go like that. That's how I did mine. I didn't go H&R Block. I just learned how to do taxes on my own. And then when I got with Stephanie, she happened to do taxes, and I learned more. And I think when I got with Stephanie, that first year, because I learned, or the second year, mm-hmm. girl, I made way more than she did.
She
okay,
she made it.
I was like, what the hell?
Like, we was doing good,
yeah,
before we started doing YouTube and kind of like slacked off a little bit, but yeah, we was doing really good. And get out of situations, whether it's family or relationships, that have you, not in a good state. Because then you're not gonna have the motivation to do shit.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. That's the big thing. You have to be in a good energy space.
Mm-hmm. Can you recall times where you were in a bad energy space and you, basically all your life wasn't really going?
All my life.
But when you got out of that, then it just like catapulted. Mm-hmm.
When we got together, every fucking thing I ever wanted to do, we've done. I've done. I mean, everything has been accomplished. I wanted to go back to school for years and never did because of situations. Mm-hmm. Okay. Never even had the motivation to like get a better job, you know, just make my situation better. Like, I was just doing enough,
mm-hmm.
you know, I was just doing enough. So, yeah, I mean, you gotta have, if you're gonna be with somebody, you need to have somebody that's gonna be a good team player with you and motivate you and support you and stuff like that.
And don't ever feel like you're too old to get like your life started now. Because I honestly really, really didn't get it together enough for me until I was like 26 years old. And that wasn't even together enough that it needed to be, but that was enough to where, okay, I'm cool. Everything is good. I ain't tripping on nothing. But it would have been better if I wasn't in the, I won't even say that. If I didn't have the energy that I had around me at that time, things would have been a lot better. Because when the energy was gone, it seemed like my life went up. When the energy came back around, it went back down. You know, and I'm talking about financially. Financially, when my energy was pure, I had more money. When my energy was bad, I had less money. I was broke. And that is just how it went. You gotta remove certain people out of your lives because they stagnate you because you're worried about... They don't stagnate you. You're stagnate because
all the bullshit.
Yes, you're so worried about that. You can't focus on what your goal is.
Exactly. Think about that shit, y'all. I'm telling you, some of these fucked up relationships be holding y'all back from living your best life.
and holds you back from taking care of your kids properly too.
Yeah. Anyway, shit. I got more to say, but I ain't gonna hold y'all.
Just say it.
I ain't gonna hold y'all. You know what I'm saying? I was just gonna say that when you said the age thing, that was huge for me because at a certain point, I felt like I was too old to go back to college. I was like, I ain't gonna be able to do it. And why? Like, why am I gonna take my old ass back? What's the point? I felt like I literally couldn't do it though, y'all. Mm-hmm. But once I started, it was like, oh, what the fuck? Why did I even think I couldn't do this?
Why?
But there was this lady, she was like, she's a black lady, y'all. Somebody knows who it is. Please put her name in the comments below if you know this story. She was like 70 or maybe even 75, could be 80, I don't know. She was pretty up there in age, y'all. She decided she was done with her, whatever she had been doing for the last 60 or 50 years, was like, I want to do something else. Went and did the new career and was like, ended up being a multimillionaire at whatever it was. I can't remember what she was doing, but when I saw that story, I was so inspired. And I was like, man, that shit is so dope. Because it's literally like, for real, don't ever stop your life.
Right.
I don't give a damn how old you are.
Exactly.
Why?
Exactly.
Why keep going. You?
Yeah. When I, Steph, thank you. Because when I said I was 26, I didn't get to my point. When I was 26 or 27, that's when I actually went to nursing school, you guys. I wasn't a nurse since I was 18. I went to nursing school when I was 28 years old. Something like, you see, I be changing ages. It was somewhere between 27, 28, 29, something. Mm-hmm. I didn't get my nursing license until then. And that's when, you know, I had more opportunities because I had something under my belt. That was the first thing that I really had under my belt. The taxes I was doing, but it wasn't, I wasn't licensed, you know, until I met Stephanie. I was like, oh, you got a license for this? Okay.
That's a good point. Learn as much as you can so you can make yourself more competitive and give yourself more opportunities for things. Mm-hmm. Just keep learning, like, forever. There's another lady who I did taxes for. She was probably 65, 70. She was girl, fancy, pretty, always kept herself up. She walked miles a day. She was going to Santa Monica College for some classes. I'm like, what?
Why not? I mean, you could go 2 years and learn something. You don't even have to go for 2 years. It depends on what you do. I went for 6 months and got a degree for computer tech and got a job instantly as soon as I was done. I didn't even need the degree. I just needed the certification, which it really took 3 months. So
stop holding yourself back. Yeah. People be like, damn, that's going to take too long. I need a job right now. But in 4 years or 2 or 4 years, whatever you know, program is, you're going to wish you had done what you needed to do. Because now you still struggling. Mm-hmm. Instead of still struggling 2 years later, you can sacrifice more and then be doing a lot better in 2 or 4 years. You know what I'm saying? Bye, y'all. I have exhausted myself talking.
That's Tasha. That's Steph. Let's go ahead and fill in the rest. We're going to eat a little, prank a little. Our story time is the best. Have you LOL when you click play? No, this ain't no clickbait. Enjoy your life. Live it up. Don't let anybody get in your way. Like, share, and comment. And don't forget to subscribe and put on your seatbelt because it's one hell of a ride.